Hi kids, today we're going skydiving. For years and years when children asked me what we were going to be doing for PE, I said that we were going to go skydiving, but I was never telling the truth. Today, I'm telling the truth. We're really going skydiving. So watch this clip so you learn about smoke jumpers, and then we're gonna jump out of a plane.
When you're a kid, you have a lot of heroes. Your parents, comic book characters, maybe a WWE superstar or two. And when you become an adult, you actually learn about even more heroes. Regular people that go that extra mile for the rest of us. While making the new movie Playing with Fire, I got a chance to learn about some of those heroes, California's smoke jumpers, and this is their story.
Smoke jumpers are firefighters who parachute into forest fires. They're often the first responders. There are only 420 smoke jumpers in the U.S. working today.
A smoke jumper is a wildland firefighter that jumps out of airplanes. They use parachutes to arrive to the fire. It takes a certain individual to do that job. They are not just physically tough, but they're mentally tough and they're resilient.
All right, kids, so there's some more instructions you need. If you see a gold ring, you need to jump in a semicircle, touch the ground, and then jump in another semicircle. So you'll do a whole circle, but you're gonna touch the ground halfway through. If you see a duck, you need to duck. That makes sense, right? And if you see a person floating below you, you need to jump over them. If they're still there, you need to jump back. You might have to jump back and forth a couple of times. If you see somebody above you and they're pointing down, you need to get on the ground and do a push-up. If they're still there when you're done, you need to do another one. All right, I hope you're ready.
She's a good girl, loves her mama, loves Jesus in America too. She's a good girl, is crazy about Elvis, loves horses and her boyfriend too. And it's a long living in Reseda, there's a freeway running through the yard. And I'm a bad boy, 'cause I don't even miss her. I'm a bad boy for breaking her heart. The vampires walking through the valley, move west down Ventura Boulevard, and all the bad boys are standing in the shadows, and the good girls are home with broken hearts.
Free falling.
She's a good girl. Loves her mama, loves Jesus. In America too, she's a good girl. She's crazy about Elvis, loves horses. And her boyfriend too. And it's a long day living in Reseda. There's a freeway running through the yard. And I'm a bad boy, 'cause I don't even miss her. I'm a bad boy for breaking her heart. Vampires walking through the valley, move west down Ventura Boulevard. And all the bad boys are standing in the shadows, and the good girls are home with broken hearts. I'm
Hi kids, I'm glad you stuck the landing. You can pretend to fight the fire for a little bit if you'd like, but I do want you to make sure that you do Coach Perillo's activity, which is coming up next. Maybe that way. Could be that way.
Activities at home. So I wanted to make some series of videos here for everybody. So with this first activity, we're going to work on rolling. And you can get some socks and roll them together. Or if you have any kind of ball around your house, that works as well. Obviously, we're in my garage. And then we're going to use a chair and some playing cards. Now, the playing cards part is optional. If your kids are very competitive kids and they want points and score, use playing cards. You can also do a few other things I'll explain as we do this. So the first thing I need to talk to you about is the proper technique of rolling. So when it comes to rolling an item on the ground, you're going to start by having your knees bent. You're going to swing your arm down and backwards. And as you make a step forward with that opposite foot, that's when you swing the arm. So I step and swing my arm forward, bending my knees and keeping it low to the ground so it rolls and stays on the ground. So in this activity, what you're going to try to do is you're going to roll the ball or socks and try to get it to go underneath the chair. If it goes underneath the chair, you've scored a point or a playing card if you're going to use the playing cards. We're going to use playing cards because we have multiple kids and, you know, they all want to compete, right? So Ben, I do my roll. If it goes underneath, which it does, I'm going to then come get my playing card. I'm going to get my balled up sock and I go back and I do it again. So I'm going to try to collect as many cards as I can. Now you can have this go as long or as short of an activity as you want for your kids. So what you could do, if you weren't using playing cards, is you can time them and you can have the kids also work together as a family and try to see how many times your family can roll this underneath the chair. So there's a couple variations right there for you. I hope you'll enjoy this one. I'm Coach Perillo reminding you to keep on moving.